Hello and welcome to Telecom TV. I'm Martin Warwick and I'm talking with John Vestal of PACnet. John, welcome. Let's start at the very basic NFV 101 sort of level. What actually are APIs?
It's a great question. You know, API, Application Program Interface, it's a way that we can interact with a system on the back end. So I may have a software system, a hardware system, I have some sort of system, and I need to be able to programmatically control that system. I don't want to have to do it through a GUI because I want to automate it, so I want my application to speak directly to that back-end system and be able to program it and tell it what to do and how to do it. The APIs allow us to do that in a way that makes it completely automated and seamless.
What role will APIs have in the network virtualized future? And more to the point, what benefits will they offer?
So the API provides us with a way to get into and control that network function, that piece that's in the middle of the network. The biggest challenge, though, is what API do you use? There's debate on going right now about, do we use a standard API or do we create our own API? And if we're creating, or if we're using a standard API, do we wait for the standard? If we look at time to market, we want to be quick, we want to be agile, we want to be the first ones to market. Standards body want to do the exact opposite. They want to be extremely slow, they want to hit every single box, they want to have a perfect solution, and they often forget about the commercial aspects, and they don't focus on the actual what a business needs to get it done. So the API is important from two perspectives. One is, how do I, as a programmer, talk to that system? But as well as, how do my customers interface with my system? Right? So we talk about northbound and southbound APIs, southbound being me talking to the NFV appliances and northbound being my customers talking to my system. And the challenge is always, how do I make it so that the same transparency that I have talking to the southbound, my customers have talking into my system? And how do we do it so I don't have to write it to 400 different APIs that are on the back end? Because every single hardware vendor and even cloud vendor has their own set of APIs at this moment.
So how do they need to be developed and implemented?
As quickly as possible. Again, my biggest challenge with APIs is standards, right? I love the idea of having a standard API because I can port my application to anything that supports that standard. But the reality of it is I have to be able to do things today. And for the way we develop APIs, it's kind of he who gets to the market first wins is kind of the standard that you see. You see that with AWS and kind of the way that they've developed their API for Direct Connect and for their cloud compute. And it's not the greatest solution, but I do think markets are going to dictate who's going to win the API wars. And we developed the API to meet the feature set that we're trying to expose. So if I want to create a router, I develop an API that says you make this call, which creates this virtual thing called a router, and this is how you control that router. And we have specific views on that. But as an operator, a carrier, my implementation will be different than the next operator, the next carrier. And that's where the standards come in. The standards become important to make sure that we're all using a similar API so that our customers don't have to write the 400 different APIs either.
What roles do the telcos, the vendors, and the developers play in this entire process?
So as the operators, we're in the position to take the services that are being developed and put a pretty face around it, if you will, put it in a nice package and deliver that package on to our customers and to the end users. So when I sit down and talk to hardware vendors or cloud operators, whoever's out there and we're trying to interface with, the first question I always ask is, give me a copy of your API, right? I want to see what features you can support at the application layer so that I can figure out, how do I take and monetize that? How do I take that application, tie it into an overall product that is being delivered to our customer, and deliver that to my customers directly? Without the close interaction between the vendor and the actual carriers, we end up failing. You end up getting products that are specific to what the vendor wants and not actually what the carrier can utilize.
What do you think would be the ideal set of APIs?
Flexibility, right? I need something that is expandable, something that allows me to know what's going to happen in the future. The biggest problem when we define an API is it's at that moment in time. And as we know, technology is increasing, you know, Moore's Law every 18 months and all those things. I need a way that I can write once and be able to expand to that without having to rewrite the entire interface that I have back to that application or into that back end. We do it with versioning. We do a few things so that version 2 is different than version 3, which is different than version 4. But now all I end up doing is having really nasty branching logic in my code to say, well, this person's using a version 2 API, so do this. And this person's using version 3, so do that. I need a way that we can have something that's consistent and actually expandable and future-proof. I wish I had a solution now, but I don't know.
John Vestal, thanks very much.
Thank you. It's been my pleasure.